morning, grade 2. Long time no see. Did you enjoy your first periodical exam? I hope that you studied a lot and enjoyed it. Today, we are going to study mathematics. Are you ready for the new chapter? So, before we proceed in our lesson, it's really important to start with a opening prayer. So, kids, follow teacher. Put your hands together, bow your head, and let's pray. God in heaven, hear my prayer. Keep me in thy loving care. Be my guide in all I do. Bless all those who love me too. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So kids, again, our subject for today is mathematics. And our lesson is addition of 2 to 4 digit numbers with regrouping. By the way, do you still remember the part of addition? So let's have a review first before we proceed in our lesson. So again, kids, addition is combining or putting together two or more numbers. Can you please repeat with teacher? Addition is combining or putting together two or more numbers. Very good. So in addition, we are using the plus sign and the equal sign. Again, we use plus sign and equal sign. So let's have here 8 plus 1. So the 8 and 1 are what we call the addends, while the answer in addition is what we called the sum. Very good. So now, let's proceed to our main topic today. Addition of 2 to 4 digit numbers with regrouping. So kids, we use regrouping in addition when the sum of the two digits in the ones place is greater than 9. Again, kids, we use regrouping in addition when the sum of the two digits in the ones place value is greater than 9. Very good. So, I have a situation here. Mrs. Josephine Dasig decided to have an outreach activity for the prisoners detained in the New Bilibid prison. She raised funds for this activity by collecting old newspaper from the students. So last Tuesday, she collected 365 kilograms of old newspapers and 187 kilograms of magazine. How many kilograms of newspaper and magazine did she collect last Tuesday? So here, again, she collected 365 kilograms of old newspapers and another 187 kilograms of old magazine. So here, kids, we need to add. So we have 365 plus 187 is equal to n. We use n because the answer is unknown. So we have here 365 plus 187. So kids, remember, when adding, you always start with the first number on your right side, which is in the ones place value. So we have here 5 plus 7 is equals to 12, right? So we are going to write 2 in the ones place value and regroup 1 in the tens place value. So now let's proceed. We need to add the tens digits, which is the 6 and 8. Plus the regroup number, which is 1. So the answer here is 13. The answer here is 15. So we need to write the 5 and then regroup the 1 number to the hundreds place value. So now let's add the hundreds digit, the digit 3, and the digit 1. Plus the regroup number 1. So the answer here is 5. So we have here the total of 555 52 kilograms of newspaper and magazine. So again, kids, Mrs. Dasig collected 552 kilograms of old newspaper and magazines. So let's have another example here. We have 573 plus 369. So again, kids, we are going to start in the right side to the ones place value. So we have here the digit 3 and the digit 9. So 9 plus 3 is equals to 12. So let's write number 2 on the ones place value. And the number 1 will be carried to the next place value, which is on the tens place value. So we have now here the tens digits. So the digit 7 and the digit 6 plus the regroup digit 1. So we have here now the total of 14. So we need to write again number 4 to the tens digit, and then we need to regroup number 1 to the hundreds place value. So we have here now, let's add the hundreds digit 5 and the hundred digit 3 plus the regroup number 1. So the answer here is 9. So we have here 942. So how about when we are using expanded form? So now, let us do addition with regrouping using the expanded notation form, okay? We have example here, 58 plus 37. Again, we have here 58 plus 37. So we need to write them in an expanded form. So let's start with 58. So the expanded form of 58 is 50 plus 8. So the 8 will remain 8 because it is on the ones place value, while the digit 5 will become 50 because it is on the tens place value. Now let's proceed to the second one, which is 37. So the number 37 will become 30 plus 7. And as you can see, 7 will remain 7 because it is on the ones place value, while the digit 3 will become 30 because it is on the tens place value. Now let's add them. We are going to start on the ones place value. So 8 plus 7 is 15, while 50 plus 30 is, very good, it is 80. So now let us expand the 80 plus 15. Let us rename 15 as 10 plus 5. So we have here 80 plus 10 plus 5. So in here, kids, we are going to add first the two numbers, which is the 80 and 10. So 80 plus 10 is equal to 90 plus 5. So the answer here is 95. Very good. How about to our next example? We have here 18 plus 14. Again, we have here 18 plus 14. So now let's write them into an expanded form. Let's start with 18. So 18 will become 10 plus 8. Because as you can see, 8 is on the ones place value, so it will remain on its value 8. While the digit 1 is on the tens place value, that's why it became 10, because it is on the tens place value. Next one is the number 14. So number 14 will become 10 plus 4. 4 is on the ones place value, so it will remain as 4. And 1 is on the tens place value, that's why it will become 10. Now 8 plus 4 is equals to 12, and 10 plus 10 is equal to 20. Very good. Now let's write them into an expanded form. 20 plus 10 plus 2. Again, we have here 20 plus 10 plus 2. So we are going to add first the two numbers, which is 20 and 10. So 20, let's group them. 20 plus 10 plus 2. So let's start with the group number, which is the 20 and 10. So 20 plus 10 is equal to 30. Let's bring down 2 plus 2. So 30 plus 2 is equal to 32. Very good, kids. Now, let's answer your math book, page 96 to 97. Come on, kids, get your math books and turn it on page 96 to 97. Now, let's start in the mind drills. Number 1. So, we have here 58 plus 37. We have here 58 plus 37. So, let's write 58 and 37 into an expanded form. Very good. Can you please follow me and write it in your book? We have here 50 plus 8. Okay, let's write it in the expanded form. 50 plus 8 is equal to 58. As you can see, 8 is on the ones place value and 5 is on the tens place value. Next one is 37. As you can see in the expanded form, 7 is on the ones place value, so it will remain 7, while 3 is on the tens place value. So it will become 30, okay? So now let's add them first. We start on the ones place value. We have 8 plus 7. So 8 plus 7 is equal to 15. Very good. Next one is 50 plus 30. So 50 plus 30 is equal to 80. Now let's write them into expanded form. 80 plus 10 plus 5. Again, 80 plus 10 plus 5. So let's regroup them. 80 and 10. Let's put them together. 80 plus 10 and then bring down 5 plus 5. So 80 plus 10, let's start with 80 plus 10. The answer is 90. Very good. Plus 5. So here we have 95. Very good, kids. Are you done? Now, let's proceed to number 2. So in number 2, we have the number 29 and 54. Again, we have the number 29 and 54. So let's write them into an expanded form. We have here, okay, let's start with 29. So 29 will become 20 plus 9. It will become 20 plus 9 because 9 is on the ones place value, so it will remain as 9 as its value. And 2 is on the seconds, on the tens place value, so it will become 20. Next one is 54, the number 54. So the number 54, if we are going to write it into an expanded form, it will become 50 plus 4. Again, it will become 50 plus 4. As you can see, 4 will remain 4 because it is on the ones place value. While 5 has the value of 50 because it is on the tens place value. So now let's add 9 plus 4 is equal to 13. Very good. While 20 plus 50 is equal to 70. Very good, kids. Now let's write them into an expanded form. It will become 70 plus 10 plus 3. Again, it will become 70 plus 10 plus 3. So now let's group it first. Let's put 70 and 10 in a group. It will become like this. 70 plus 10 plus 3. So let's add the number 70 and number 10. So the answer is 80 plus 3. So we have here 83. Very good. Next one is 563 plus 454. Again, we have here 563 plus 454. So let's write them into an expanded form. So as you can see here, 563 is written as 500 plus 60 plus 3. Again, 563 is written as 500 plus 60 plus 3. 3 is on the 1's place value, so it will remain as 3. 6 is on the 10's place value, so the value of 6 is 60. And the digit 5 is on the 100's place value, so the value of its number is 500, okay? Next one, let's proceed to the second number, which is 454. The second number is 454, and it is written as 400 plus 50 plus 4. Again, 454 is written as 400 plus 50 plus 4. 4 will remain 4 because it is on the 1's place value. The digit 5 is on the 10's place value, so it will become 50. And the digit 4 is on the 100's place value, that's why it become 400. So when we are adding, always start with the 1's place value. Very good. So 3 plus 4 is equal to 7. Very good, kids. Next one, 60 plus 50 is equal to 110. While 500 plus 400 is equal to 900. So let's write them into an expanded form. 900 plus 100 plus 10 plus 7. Again, 900 plus 100 plus 10 plus 7. Okay, let's group the first two numbers, which is 900 and 100. So 900 plus 100 is equal to 1000. Bring down the 10 and 7. We will bring down the 10 and 7. So we have here 1000 plus 10. So it will become 1010 plus 7. So 1010 plus 7 is equal to 1017. Again, it is equal to 1017. Next number, 7472. Again, 7472 plus 1823. Again, 7472 plus 1823. So let's write them into an expanded form. Let's start with the first number, which is 7,472. We are going to write it into an expanded form as 7,000 plus 400 plus 70 plus 2. Okay? Again, 7,000 plus 400 plus 70 plus 2. So, next one, we have 1,823. Again, 1,823. It will become 1,000 plus 800 plus 20 plus 3. Again, it will become 1,000 plus 800 plus 20 plus 3. So, we will have 3 plus 3 is equal to 6. 70 plus 20 will become 90. 800 plus 400, it will become 1,200, and 7,000 plus 1,000 will become 8,000, okay? So let's write them into an expanded form. Let's start with 8,000 plus 1,000. So here we have 9,000 plus 200 plus 20 plus 5. Next one is 9,200 plus 90 plus 5. Next one, we have 9,290 plus 5. So the answer is 9,295. Okay, we are done to the page 96 to 97. So now let's proceed to the use of short method. So kids, here you need to listen carefully and use this as your guide in answering your math book. Page 97 to 98. So, you need to listen carefully, okay? So, let's proceed using the short method. So, you need to write the numbers vertically. So, we have here 18 plus 14. And we are going to start answering in the right side, which is the ones place value. So we have the digit 8 and the digit 4. So again, 8 plus 4 is equal to 12. So we need to write number 2 on the ones place value and then regroup the digit 1 in the tens place value. So now in the tens place value, we have the digit 1 plus 1 plus 1 because of the regroup number. So we have here 32. Okay, the answer is 32. 18 plus 14 is equal to 32. Next example, we have 23 plus 18. Again, we have 23 plus 18. So we have here 3 plus 8. We are going to the ones place value, okay? Start with the ones place value. 3 plus 8 is equal to 11. So the digit on the ones place value is the digit 1. So we need to write it. And the another one, which is on the tens place value, we are going to regroup it. So now, in the tens place value, we have the numbers 1 plus 2 plus 1. So the answer here is 4. Very good. So 23 plus 18 is equal to 41. So that is the short method. So the key points of this lesson is, the first one, in adding 2 to 4 digit number, you start from right to left. Again, kids, always remember this. You start from right to left. And always start on the ones place value, okay? And the second one, if the sum of the digit in a column is higher than 9, regroup to the next higher place value. Then add from the ones place value to the next one, okay? So kids, kindly answer your math book on page 97 to 100, okay? Make sure that you answer your math book page 97 to 100. So I hope kids that you learned a lot. So that will be all and see you on our next class. Bye!